Hello and welcome to part one of this lion and luna moth page from Mythographic Aviary. So I'm starting here with my Neo 2 in Sahara Yellow and just basically laying down a solid base layer for all of the lion's mane, his ears, and his face. And then I'm going to come back in with my Prismacolors and add all of the colors and shading. So once I have laid down all of the Neocolor, then I will activate it. And then once it has completely dried, I will go back in with those Prismacolors. So once we get to that point in the video, I will kind of give you some more details on how I approached coloring his mane. Okay, so now that that Neocolor base layer has completely dried, I'm going in with my Espresso and just starting to add some shading. You can see where the artist had already indicated shading, so it makes it really easy to put in those darker colors. And I'm just using flicking motions, so my approach with doing this lion mane and fur is to just treat it like I would hair on a portrait. So I'm using that Espresso for my shadows. Then I'm going to come in with my Sienna Brown and kind of overlap that shadow area and extend out from that just as if I were coloring hair. And then I will come in with my goldenrod and just add some little golden areas. And all the while, I want to try to leave some uncolored areas, which will act as the highlights, because you will have the Neo 2 kind of showing through in those areas. So that will be the perfect highlight for these strands of hair. So I hope that that makes sense. It's pretty easy. It's just kind of tedious. There's so much hair around his mane. So it did take quite a while. But the end result was just gorgeous. So stick with it. And let me know if you have any questions. Oh, and one last thing too is, don't worry if your flicking with the hair goes outside of the border of the image, because after all is said and done on this picture, I am going to be adding kind of a thicker border around the edge using a ruler and filling it in, so it kind of just covers up all of that going outside of the line as far as the edge of the image there. All right, so I finished all of the mane, but on the left side, you can see that I added a lot more shading and outlining of the tendrils, I guess, or the sections of fur. So I wanted to come back and show you how I did that a little bit more in depth for the right side of his mane. So you can kind of see the difference between the left side and the right side, how it's just got that extra definition and texture. So what I am doing is just basically outlining the most prominent sections of hair or fur, and that just makes those kind of pop out even more and gives it that extra definition. So as I am putting in all of the shading on the right side, I am going through and adding those outlines, and it just really gives the page a lot more realism, and you know, I just think it looks great. So So again, as far as shading on the face and the shadows, here where I am laying down the espresso, I'm just kind of going over where the artist had already indicated that shadow and shading areas with the line work, and I'll just continue doing that for the rest of the face, and then coming back in with that Sienna Brown and Goldenrod. Okay, so yeah, with the face fur, I just kind of go back and forth between the espresso and the Sienna Brown and the Goldenrod, and just kind of affecting it to how I want it to look, adding more shadow and shading here and there. And it's all about personal preference. And just, you know, kind of work with it until you're happy with the result. All right, so this concludes part one for this page. And part two, we should be finishing the page. We will be starting on that Luna moth in the center there, and hopefully finishing the rest of the page. So thank you for watching, and I'll see you in part two.